good day to all. My name is Mr. Roshanan Coelho from the Department of Hospitality Science, Milagros College, Mangalore. So topic that I am dealing with today is the various energy resources and its types. So we'll go through today which are the various types of energies that are available on the planet Earth. So first one, the resources. Basically the resources is the things that are available to us. So they are basically distinguished between two things, that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. So first one, we'll learn about the natural resources that are available in the environment. So as the name says, natural resources, that is from the nature. So those energies can be the wind energy, the solar energy, the tidal energy, the water energy. So anything that is produced from nature is termed as natural resources. So these resources once again are sub-classified or categorized into two main variables. Those are renewable sources of energy and non-renewable sources of energy. So first today we'll learn the renewable sources of energy. What are renewable resources? So as the name says, it is renewable or it can be replenished again even after using it heftily. So basically these are termed as infinite resources. There is a never-ending process. It is always available in nature. So what are the examples of renewable energy? So we have the solar energy, we have the wind energy, we have the tidal energy, we have the geothermal energy, we have the nuclear energy. So basically these are all renewable resources. So basically we all know the use of solar energy. We have something called as a solar panel that uses the photovoltaic effect to produce electricity. As the sun rises, the radiation, that is the solar radiation, is captured by the solar panels and then it is converted into electricity and then it is sent to the home or any other city, and there it is converted into the required volts that is needed. Then we have the wind energy. Basically, as you can see in the picture over here, this is a classic windmill with a 6-blade fan, but the present modern era windmills are of 3-blade fans. So what happens is when the wind rod hits the blade, it starts rotating, and due to this rotation there is a kinetic energy built up there, and that is how we get electricity. Next, as you can see in the picture, now we have something called as a hydroelectric power plant. So basically what happens is this is mainly near a dam. Let's say there's a dam, as you can see in the picture there, there's a dam there. So when they release the water, what happens is there is a high amount of pressure that is released there now, because of the force of water and also due to the force of gravity over there. So when this water hits the turbine, there are hydroelectric turbines placed at the bottom there. So when the water hits these turbines, what happens is there's a rotation force gathered there, and this rotation force thus produces the energy required, and the energy is first transferred to a nearby power plant, and from that power plant it is sent to the particular city or a town according to the required volts. The next form of energy, as you can see in the picture depicted here, is the geothermal energy. As the name states, geothermal. Geo means earth, thermal means heat. So basically what happens is, as you can see in the picture, we have something called as a core. The earth has a core which is a molten lava. It is basically a melting form of lava. It is very, very hot on the surface of that core. Basically it's something like a mini sun, we can term it as. So what are the uses of geothermal energy? Basically in foreign countries where you have high amounts of cold, they use heating systems. Now for these heating systems, they can use this particular geothermal method where it gathers the heat from the earth and it is then transferred to the household or any other buildings that it requires heating. So next type of energy is the biomass. So basically what does biomass mean? That is basically made out of plants and animal waste that can be converted into energy. As you can see, there are different types of biomass. In the first picture, you can see the burning of wood. We can burn wood and thus we can attain heat energy. Next is the wooden crops, or the crops, basically crops like corn and sugarcane. They can be converted into a biofuel called as ethanol. Basically, it's a highly flammable liquid. So basically, we can convert into an ethanol. Next is the animal waste that is produced by the animals, so they can be turned into fertilizers and thus once again helping us to yield cultivation as well. So these were all the renewable resources. So now we are moving on to the what do we mean by non-renewable resources. So as the term says, these are not renewable, that is this cannot replenish. Once we use this, it is done, it is empty, but it will So now we move on to non-renewable resources. As the name states, it is non-renewable, that is it cannot replenish. Once we use it, it is done. It is So now we move on to non-renewable resources. So what are non-renewable resources? As the name states, these are non-renewable in nature. That is, they cannot be replenished. So once we use them, it is done. It is empty. So which are the types of non-renewable resources that we use? Basically, the major thing that we use is the fossil fuels. So as you can see there, the coal, the natural gas. So basically, we rely on these certain things right now. And as you can see right now, the cost of all these things are sky high because of the shortage of these kind of particular fuels. That is why currently right now we are moving from the era of as you see in the automobile industry, we were dependent upon the petrol and diesel engines. But currently right now we are moving towards the electric generation or the water generation. Basically, the electric generation, you might have heard the term Tesla. Basically, it was founded by Elon Musk, where everything is run by electricity. And currently right now another form of technology is being formed, that is the hydrocell technology. Basically, your vehicles will run on water, that is the purest form of water, that is hydrogen. So these things are coming up right now as to fight back with the shortage of these kind of fuels. So burning of fuels are harmful for the environment as well. When we burn coal or any other kind of fuel, they produce some kind of particulates or some kind of emissions. So basically carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, or any kind of other harmful substances that get mixed along with the atmosphere. And that is the same thing that we breathe. And again, once again, it is effective to the human health as well as the animal and plant life. So why are the natural resources important? Why can't we focus completely on natural resources? Being the smartest beings on the planet Earth, why can't we use these natural resources? There are some political as well as some selfish reasons as well, because when we move towards natural resources, what happens is there are certain tech giants, or what we say, oil companies, they do not want to opt with the new upcoming resources. Why is it? Because they will lose their market, and that is how they will lose their fame. So that is the reason they keep on insisting on bringing up new things, and that is why they do not agree with the clean version of the fuels. And with this, I end my lecture for today's topic. Thank you.